Jessie.
Science is fun, but you have questions, so I'm here to answer them in a relatable way. Today's question comes from Ian at Skybound.
Ian?
Thanks for letting me ask a question, Jessie. My question is, what is DNA and how is it used to catch bad guys? Take it away.
I think you're talking about forensic science?
The crime science that helps catch all the bad guys.
But before we can put bad guys in jail, we have to catch them and prove that they did something bad. That can be a little bit tricky, but things like DNA profiling can help us put those bad guys away. DNA profiling is kind of what it sounds like. It's essentially profiling us using our unique DNA. I'm gonna go ahead and Russian doll this. We are all made up of cells. Each cell contains a copy of your individual genome. Your genome is comprised of 46 little packages of your genetic material called chromosomes. These chromosomes contain your genes. Your genes are made up of denim. Just kidding. Your genes are made up of DNA. Your DNA is made up of four letters, G, A, C, and T, repeated and arranged in an extraordinarily clever way that when put together, it builds you. You know, that seems crazy. Our instructions come in arrangements of just four letters, but think of it kind of like binary. All software that exists, no matter how complicated, can be distilled down to only two digits, which may or may not make the robot superior to us in the end. Okay, so your DNA is utterly, absolutely, totally, and completely unique to you. But remember, there's a copy of your DNA in every single cell inside and outside of your body. Without DNA, a cell is like a Pokeball without a Pokemon, just a useless container. So the thing about cells is, we tend to leave them behind. It's just kind of like when a basilisk sheds its skin, just on a much tinier level. But we do leave our cells behind in skin flakes, saliva, blood, hair, toenails, etc. Imagine basically that all of our genetic information and everything about us is on like these little USB drives, and everywhere we go, we're just like, here's a copy, here's a copy, here's a copy, here's a copy. So that doesn't bode well if you're trying to get away with murder, though. Forensic science uses all sorts of techniques like fingerprint collection and bloodstain pattern analysis, but debatably, the biggest game changer of them all in the past century has been DNA profiling. Like a game of concentration or go fish, once DNA is recovered from a crime scene, it's essentially a matching game with potential suspects and or criminals on file. So in summary, your DNA is completely unique to you, and this helps forensic scientists to catch the bad guys when they leave their DNA behind and they get to go and analyze those things in the lab, deliver them as evidence, and catch the bad guys. Keeping you safe, Ian. That's all for this episode, folks. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you, Ian, for your question. Everyone else, please comment below and write to us on Twitter. I'm at Jessie Science. This is at Gamma Ray TV. Send in your questions for future episodes. And don't forget to subscribe for all sorts of awesome videos, and let us know your favorite crime show.